on now. Why are you looking at it weird? All right, guys, so we're back. We're out here in the woods. We're going to try to do a little squirrel hunt today. I got my boy Kaleb with me again. He's pretty embarrassed at the camera, so just kind of bear with him. Yeah. Instead of talking, he just makes funny little noises. Anyways, so we're going to head right down this road here and see if we can get on some squirrels. Job. All right, so we're back at the truck. We got a squirrel. We're gonna clean it and cook it for you guys. Kind of see how we do it. Kaleb was the lucky one. He got to shoot the squirrel. You got anything to say, boy?
I shot it with a 20 gauge with bird shot.
Bird shot.
Huh?
Bird shot.
Yeah, bird shot.
Now, why'd you use bird shot and not buckshot?
Because you don't use buckshot, because if you want buckshot, then you're going to shoot a hog or a buck.
Yeah. Okay, is it because the pellets are a lot smaller in bird shot?
Yeah, way smaller.
Okay. Alright, so we're gonna clean this thing up. It's already got dark out here. Try to do this pretty quick. First thing I do is cut their little tail off. I'm gonna cut all of his feet. Alright, so get all his feet cut off, get his tail cut off. And the next thing you want to do is just cut his head off. You want a pretty sharp knife because you got to cut through bone and everything else. So when you get that done, just come right here on his back. And you just want to make a little cut here. right through the skin. You don't want to cut into the meat. But you just want to cut that skin enough to get your fingers in. Just like that. And you just peel this off. One half. Just like that. Keeps all the hair off of it. You want to get all those little guts out of there. Just take and cut this. Just cut this flap here off. Split the breastbone, lay him open. The way you get all the innards out, man, you don't want none of that in your meat. It'll ruin the taste of that meat. So get all of this inside stuff out of here, man. Okay, so got the squirrel here, our little buddy cleaned up. I'm gonna take a paper towel, dry it all off real good. Flip it over. See, I've got it butterflied out. Got it butterflied out so that it'll lay down flat when you're frying it. Trying to draw the water off of it, make the seasoning stick to it real good. Okay, so once you get your meat cleaned up, dried off, you just want to sprinkle some seasoning on this boy. You can be generous. A lot of it's going to come out in the fryer. Using plain old iodized sea salt and slap your mama. That's my stuff right there. Spread him out like this. Good and seasoned on this side. sprinkle some of this on it. Now, while that's kind of soaking in, we'll take a regular old cast iron skillet. Medium heat. Olive oil. I'm gonna let that heat up. Alright, oil's getting pretty hot. I'm gonna take this bad boy. Actually, I can't find my tongs. So I'm not going to improvise. Okay, so once you get it good and brown on both sides, you just want to stick this stuff over here for a minute. I'm gonna rinse that oil out. Put them back in the pan. Typically I add some tomatoes or something to put in there to steam down a little bit. Put some of this vegetable soup today. I'm So, like I was saying, typically I pour some tomatoes and stuff like that on top of him, just let him stew for a while, because it really tenderizes the meat, and you don't want to eat no tough squirrel, I can promise you. I'm sorry about all the background noise. I've asked them to be quiet and they won't, so that's babies for you, I guess. But once this comes to a boil like that, typically just turn it down to a simmer. And I'm just gonna let this thing stew in here until it tenders up real good.
Okay, it's done, right?
It's done.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's done. It's tender. See that?
Yeah,
but it's done.
That's what it looked like. I guess it's done. If it's done, it's done, I guess.
Looks
delicious.
You want some of this to go with it?
Yeah. I certainly do. Okay, we're good. Well, let's cut it down real quick.
There you go, boy. Some squirrel.
Might cool down a little bit.
Yeah.
Hot.
You get a knife and cut it if you have to.
Okay, I'm gonna take the first bite of the squirrel.
How is it?
It's pretty soft. Tastes pretty good. It has like a I don't know, I think the soup really put a lot of flavor into it.
Should be good and tender. It stewed down in that soup for about 45 minutes, so. You like it?
Yeah.
Huh?
I like it.
Not bad.
Yeah, pretty good.
All right, guys, that's it. So, squirrel's been cooked. Caleb's chowing down. I think that's it, man. We're gonna call it a night. Finish eating. See y'all next time.